Good morning, children. Today we are going to learn block 10, leisure. In that we will see S3 and S4. So what is S3, children? S, author's perspective, and S4 is writing a poem. And at the end of this particular video, you will be able to identify and compare author's perspectives on life. What is that? So you will be able to identify, you will be able to find out the authors, what is their view on life. And the other one is, you will be able to write a poem on a good life. So we know what is a good life in leisure poem, which we have already done it. So you will be able to write a poem also. Now let us move on to the next slide, that is keywords. Now the first word is quote. Quote means it is the sayings of famous personalities. Now here you can see Mahatma Gandhiji. A quote is written over here, that is his words. The future depends on what you do today. So this is the quote which is written by Mahatma Gandhiji. So what does this mean, children? Yes, whatever you do it today. So based on that your future is. So today if you are very good, learn the things very well and do all the things which are necessary for a student life, like acquiring knowledge, all that if you do it, then your future will be very nice, you'll be successful. So famous personalities give some quotations or quotes. So if we follow that, we will lead, we will step into success, isn't it, children? Now the next word is perspective. So what is this perspective? Perspective is a view, or a view of an author, okay, a view of a person. So certain thing is there, what is the view of it? So some lines are there, what is your view on that? Okay, that is called as perspective. The next one is point of view. So point of view means some situation is given, what is your point of view on that? So that is, what is your attitude, what is your opinion about that particular thing? Okay, that is called as point of view. The next one is good life. So good life, in our poem we have learned. So what is good life? Good life is a person who enjoys the nature, or who takes out some time for himself to enjoy the nature, or to do the things which he loves to do it. So that is called as a good life. So he also tells that we need to lead a good life. Okay, children. So now you are all familiar with the keywords. Now before we move on to the next slide, let us do one small activity. Okay, bring a cup, children, and place it on a table and sit in front of it. Okay, and then you draw the cup. Okay, pause the video and you do it, children. First you listen to the instruction. So first, what are you going to do it? First, you will bring the cup, place it on a table, sit with one A4 size paper and a pencil, then sit in front of that particular cup and then start drawing it. After doing the first drawing, then change your position, okay? Move towards the right side, left side, or the opposite direction. You move your place, change your place, and then draw. So three drawings you draw it, children. Pause the video and do this particular activity. Okay, then we will continue. Okay, very good. Now let us see your drawing, how it is. Yes, probably it might be like this. Okay, so all the three drawings are not same, isn't it, children? Okay, all the three drawings which you have done it, they are different. So it is only the one cup only, same cup. But why the drawings are different? Are they wrong? Is anything wrong here, over here? Yes? No. Very good, children. Why? Because why the drawings are different? Because you have drawn that particular cup from a different position. So your position was changed. So you have come to the different angle and you have drawn it. So when you have changed the position, the view, your view looking at that particular cup changes. Okay, isn't it? Now we'll see another one, children. Here, look at the pegs of a chair. So a chair's pick is taken from different angle. So you can see the different view of the chair. So in the same manner as we have seen the cups and the chairs, we come across people who look at certain thing in a different way. They see, understand and think in a different way. So each and every person's view, understanding and looking at the thing differs. Okay, now we'll move on to the next one. Now look at our father of nation, Mahatma Gandhiji. His quote is written over here. The main purpose of life is to live rightly, think rightly and act rightly. So now let us know what is this. Okay, what does he want to convey? What does he want to say? So he tells us that a life spent in doing and thinking right things is the right kind of life. So he says, what is a right kind of life? How to lead a right kind of life? So what is a right kind of life? That is to live rightly, to do the right things, to think right and to act right. So that is a right kind of life. So about life he says in this particular way. So I have put the words together for you. I'll read it for you in the next slide. Mahatma Gandhiji wants to tell us that a life spent in doing and thinking right things is the right kind of life. Is this clear, children? Now we'll move on to the next one. So what message does the poem Leisure gives us? Okay, what message does the poem which we have done it that give us? So what message does it give, children? We have already learned in our previous video. Yes, it says that people should not be too busy doing their work, doing their routine work. They should not be too busy doing their regular thing or the routine work in the life. They should take out some time in order to do certain other activities which are of their interest, or to spend some time with the nature, to look at the nature, to see the nature and enjoy and appreciate the nature. Look at the animals, look at the birds, look at the clouds, sky, which are very beautiful to look at it, to enjoy. So we have to see them and enjoy our life. So that is what the poem Leisure message it gives us. So I have put the words together for you all, children. So the poem wants to give us the message that people should not be very busy in doing the regular things in life. They should take out time to enjoy the little things in life, such as beautiful things in nature. Is this clear? So this is the message which we get from the poem Leisure. Now we'll move on to the next one. So here we have learned about what Gandhiji wanted to say. So what Gandhiji said, what is same which he had said, that is leading a life. So we have to lead a right kind of life. Okay, and in Leisure poem also it is said the same thing, how we should lead a life. So how we have to lead a life? We have to enjoy our days. We should not spend most of our time in doing the work. We have to take out some time and enjoy the nature and appreciate the nature. That is a good life. So that is also leading a life. How we should lead a life, it is said in Leisure poem as well as in the quotation given by Mahatma Gandhiji, isn't it, children? Now William Henry Davies, who has written this Leisure poem, what he says, leading a life by finding out time to enjoy and appreciate the beauty in nature. So he says the same thing, how to lead a life. So how we should lead our life, how we have to lead, we have to take out our time, find out some time in order to enjoy and appreciate the beauty in nature by looking at the trees, clouds, sky, okay, animals, all that, so that we'll get relaxed. Now what does Mahatma Gandhiji said in the quotation? Life spent in doing and thinking the right things is a good life. Doing good deeds is also important. So how the life has to be led? So it is said by Mahatma Gandhiji same, as well as Henry Davis also, he also said the same thing. So Mahatma Gandhiji, he says that we have to lead a good life by doing the right things. Okay, children. Now look at this particular picture. So here you come across a American a poet as well as an author. He is Walt Whitman, and he has written a poem that is Leaves of Grass. It is poetry as well as prose. So from his poetry, one line is taken for our study in the workbook. Now open your workbook to page number 12. S3, author's perspective. Now first one, read the following line. See the line, children. Do anything but let it produce joy. It is written by Walt Whitman. That is from the book Leaves of Grass, which we have already seen in the previous slide. Now you need to write the meaning of this particular line. So what is the line? Do anything but let it produce joy. So write its meaning in your own words. So do anything. Do anything means you can do anything. Okay. But let it produce joy. Let it means that whatever the action which you are doing it, it should give you happiness. Not only to you, but also to your friends, parents also, it should give happiness. That is to others. You should not harm anyone. By your action, you should not harm anyone. But whatever the action which you are doing it, it should give happiness to everyone. So that is the meaning of this particular line. Is this clear, children? Now see the second question. How is the message in this line the same as the message of the poem Leisure? Now we know the message of the poem Leisure. And now message in this line refers to the line which is there on the top, that is do anything but let it produce joy. So how this line is same as the message of the poem Leisure? So how both are same? Yes, both are telling us about the kind of life to be led by people. Okay, so in the first one, Walt Whitman, in that, what does that poet say? That you can do certain actions which produces happiness, which gives you happiness. But and also in Leisure, what it is said, you have to take out some time. You have to spend some time on observing the nature or on enjoying the nature. So both are same, isn't it, children? Now we will move on to the next one. How is Whitman's message different from the poem? So poem is our Leisure. Now Whitman's message. So what is Whitman's message which we have written in the first one? What message did he give us? That whatever the actions which we perform, it should give happiness to us and also to others. That is his message. Now what is the message of the poem? Okay, what is the message of the poem? In the poem, what does it tell us, that Leisure poem? It tells us to value small things which are around us. So what are the small things which are around us? That is the nature. So we have to value the nature. We have to look at the nature. We have to enjoy the nature. We have to appreciate the nature. Okay, so in this way, both are different. So why Whitman's message is that you have to enjoy, or whatever the action which you are doing, it should give you happiness. It gives happiness. And what about this Leisure one? You have to take out some time in order to observe the nature. Okay, children, in this way, this messages from the Whitman's message and the Leisure poem message, in this way, they are different. Now see the next one, third one. What things make you feel joy in your life? Write in three sentences. That means whatever the things which you do in your life which gives you happiness, that you have to write in three sentences. Put number one sentence, next sentence, then third sentence. Is this clear, children? Third one, clear? Now we'll move on to S4. Very simple one, children. You'll enjoy doing it. Writing a poem. Fill the word web with things that you think make your life good. Okay, so here this is a word web, children. In the middle, what it is given? A good life is. So now you need to tell what is a good life according to you, in your opinion, what it is. A good life is, a good life is, whatever, what it is. So what is a good life according to you? Yes, you can write in the webs here. So some of them will discuss, children. Yes, first thing is you can say that a good life is for you playing games, isn't it? A good life is playing games, or good life is to talk with friends, or good life is to enjoy with friends. Okay. A good life is going to a party, going to a shopping mall, okay, spending time with family, okay, going to a restaurant also, children, isn't it? Okay, and also observing the nature, singing songs, okay, dancing with friends, okay, isn't it? So in this way, anything you can write it. Okay, now we'll move on to the next slide. Now look at the second one. Use the above word web to write your own poem about a good life. Now, in the poem Leisure, children, we have come across the word, we have no time is given. Isn't it, children? Now, here, you see here, what a good life this is, if full of, we have time to. So, we are changing that particular phrase from no time to time to. Okay, so we have time to. So, now we have plenty of time, children, to write it. Okay, what a good life this is if full of, so on the top you have written some word web, no? So from that you can write full of friends. So with full of friends you'll be very happy. Okay, we have time to, so you have time to what to do it, that you can write from the word web. Whatever we have discussed right now, that you can write. We have time to, again, for what you have time, what you will feel very much enjoyable, that you can write. And we have also time to do these things. Like that you continue. So in word web, whatever you have written, that you can write, or something else also, which you feel that it is good for you, or which you feel that you can enjoy the life. And also you write a title for your poem. Whatever you are writing, what is that you are writing about a good life. So you can write My Good Life as a poem, or Good Life. Okay. So like that you write the title of the poem. Is this clear, children? From the word web, you selected, four are there. You can write four or some other things, whatever we have discussed, based on that you write. Is this clear, children? Have you all understood? Thank you.